hello, Dolbeds at Blog here. And I'm in Gatwick. I haven't got my adventure hat because it's getting too ragged for proper different country adventuring. It's more a festival hat now. And yes, I'm just waiting to go to Japan. Going to go to Dubai first, 2 hours in Dubai, and then on to Tokyo. Here I am in my hotel. It was a bit of a journey getting here. I had the deep end fear of just suddenly going, I really don't know where I'm going, what I'm doing. But luckily, two ladies helped me out and put me on the right path, showed me how to use the ticket machine, and now I'm here in my room. And it's quite small, compact bijou. Got a little bunk bed there, which I'm sort of consolidating my bags down. And then got a bit of gap underneath there. Little desk. And they provide you with some house slippers. And they also provide you with this very handsome dressing gown. And I'm very tired. I think I'm going to go and have a shower. And then tomorrow morning I can explore properly. And my first night's sleep. It was very nice, although I woke up at 4 in the morning. Thank you, jet lag. And it is now 8 in the morning. It's already pretty hot, so I'm going to find breakfast. And I saw a sign saying a hearty vegetable soup for breakfast, so I'm going to find that. So I've got silky tofu, assorted vegetables, dumpling I've had so far in there, some deep fried tofu, Chinese leaf, I guess Japanese leaf here. It's very good. I'm definitely going to have to get a sun hat though. It's only just 9 o'clock and I'm already very hot. I've got to make sure I keep my water up and get a sun hat. I'm going to go exploring. There was a strange lump of something gelatinous, but I'm not sure what it was at all. Strange don't know whether it's just a bit of stock or something like that. I did try do a bit of Japanese from my Japanese phrase book, as is the way generally when I'm doing languages. The locals looked at me confused and I ended up just showing them the word vegetarian and she said yes. So that's all right there. Job I need to do is get some new dye. diary because I forgot one. So the receptionist at the hotel gave me instructions for somewhere to go to. Then get him on the tube, which I'm on now. Got it. It's in a confusing big shop selling everything and lots of it with music playing. But anyway, people are getting on the tube now, so I'm going back to the hotel to write my diary and find a local park to maybe do my press ups and perhaps do some sketches. And I've still got to find a hat. And then this evening I'm going to go to the Wishless Gallery, which will be exciting. Sitting down, just enjoying a temple. I'm not sure which temple this one is, but while I was here I thought I'd get some Hokkari Sweat as a refreshing drink to replace my dull bedsit bloggery sweat, I guess. I might do some drawings while I'm here. Tofu in hot sauce. It wasn't chili hot, it was just hot. And I thought, oh, it'd be nice to have something sweet. Maybe I can try the weird Japanese Kit Kats that you get. These ones are green tea flavour. Yes, I've heard about them. So let's give them a go. I wouldn't normally get Kit Kats, but you know, due to the Nestle connection, but oh well, I'm on holiday. Right, come on. Oh, so I'm having trouble getting into it one-handed. Little mini fingers. Kind of like a Kit Kat really, but a little bit more creamy maybe. Yeah, alright. Back to having some breakfast. Nice vegetable soup again. My breakfast place. It kept me sustained all day yesterday. Didn't have anything until it's like quite late. I had a
tofu in a hot sauce with some rice. So I got a rice cake as well, just to sop up the juice. Yesterday evening went to found the Wishlist Gallery, which is good. And I spoke to Rob and Yoko about the possibility of having a fanzine that I'm going to make during my travels. All worked out all right. And they also took a couple of Neustrata Fjord records to sell in their gallery. It's very exciting. So if you're in Tokyo and you have the urge for some radish, go to Wishlist Gallery. I was very excited to see that Rec, who's a Brighton artist, graffiti writer, crowded this an exhibition there. And then also Nylon, who is another one of my sort of, like, kind of vague graffiti heroes, had a show at Wishlist, and we chatted about things, and they gave me some great places to go when I'm back in Tokyo, because once I finish this and I pack properly, I'm off to Shinjuku City to go and watch wrestling for my birthday present to me, because it's my birthday today. Woohoo! Happy birthday to me, happy birthday to me, happy birthday to me, happy birthday to me. Let's have a look at my room. I've got a small double bed there and a little desk. Well, hello there. And a toilet and a kind of a Japanese sit down bath shower thing, and then you got your soap, rinse and shampoo, and I have to do a thing about the toilets and their water pressure. Oh, this is a different one. I'll have to try this out later, maybe a video, I don't know. Is it the done thing to watch someone have a jet of water go up their bum hole? Anyway, let's turn the light off there. And then we can look out and see what Shinjuku City looks like. It's been raining. I did start to walk here. It would be about a 15-minute walk, but my bag was heavy, and it was difficult. It's hard, and so I ended up getting a taxi, and just as it started to rain, so that was kind of lucky. Although I'd have walked in the rain, as well as being hot and sticky and sweltery, so
just chilling out here for a bit. Might throw some water at my face and then go off and find the wrestling, which is quite exciting. So I made it here. Wasn't quite sure if I was on the right bus for a bit, and then I had to ask at the police station over there where it was. They just pointed me over here. And it's raining. I didn't bring the waterproof cover for my camera, which is a bit annoying. So I'm soaking wet. And it's feeling very much like a British wrestling show at the moment. Looks like it's in a hall. I've paid my 7,000 yen. And yes. So, birthday wrestling shenanigans should ensue. It's like being in Worthing, but with a bigger ring.
So, it's the 28th today, and last night was an interesting night. First of all, I got to see the wrestling, Noah wrestling, and it was everything I kind of wanted out of coming to Japan to see a wrestling show. It was so comfortingly like going to Worthing, but a different style of wrestling in the ring. A small hall with not that many people in it. Very quiet audience, a lot quieter than a British wrestling audience, which I'd known about, but I didn't realise quite how quiet they'd be. And one of the great things was there's one of the wrestlers was someone that I've seen in Worthing, and he did look across at me and said, "Oh." I think possibly because you might not get that many Western tourists in Shizuoka. So that was kind of good. There was some good comedy matches, some hard hitting stuff, crazy stuff going to the audience, all sorts. And then to get to that, I had to get a train and a bus from Shizuoka, and got the train and the bus and the train back. Got back to the hotel, kind of relaxed and chilled out there. A moment, and I thought, I'm quite hungry, I haven't had anything to eat since my hearty vegetable soup. A bullet train, not my one, I want the next one. I then went out for a walk. It rained. I forgot to say, there was a lot of rain last night. So walking through the rain, which is really nice. It was warm rain.
made a change from the hot, wet air. This is actually genuinely wet. So I thought, oh, well, I'll try and go out and find a noodle place. I can sit on the street, the reflective light of neon, and eat some noodles. And I found the Teddy Boys Bar, which is a rock and roll themed bar. And I, so, I saw the outside, and thought, oh, that looks interesting. I do feel a little bit, I did miss out a little bit because it wasn't the case of I'm going to try and go to the Japanese bar. This one looks a bit more familiar. Yeah, so I went in there and had a couple of beers in there. Very flirty barmaid. Chatted with a traveling salesman. We used gestures, drawing, iPads, iPhone apps to communicate. And then, so that was a great fun night. So now I'm heading off to Osaka.
So, this is my home from home for 3 days. Capsule thing. In Osaka. So, yeah. I'm gonna have a shower. It was hard finding here.
One of the things on my to-do list was to try natto, and I've got a natto curry here, so I'm going to try it and I'll tell you what it was like. I'm a bit self-conscious to film myself eating in this small cafe. I'd heard bits about natto, fermented soya beans, which they're whole and they're kind of slimy and they've got more protein in them than before they were fermented. It's supposed to have quite a distinctive flavour. It wasn't as strong as I was thinking. It was more the texture, quite a slimy texture, but after a few mouthfuls you could taste an almost like a slightly Marmite-y thing going on. I definitely want to try natto again. And if you're in Japan and you're vegetarian, I recommend these cafes, Curry House Koko, because they've got a selection of vegetarian foods, and it's very good. Natto is good. So I'm going to go further on my adventures.
I thought I'd do a quick catch up. Yesterday didn't quite go to plan really. I had planned to go to Kyoto so I could visit the Power Rangers museum that's there, but when I woke up it was raining. It rained some more and it was like typhoon. Eventually it eased up a bit. By then it was about 1 o'clock. So I got my stuff together, bought an umbrella. I hate umbrellas. And walked to the tube station to get the train. And in trying to find the right tube station, went to the information. They gave me a different route that they said was better, get the rapid train. And I thought they meant directly to the stop I needed. So I stayed on after Kyoto, went on for a while. And then I had to ask someone on the train, does this train stop at here? I said no, so I had to get off and go back. By the time I get the train to Kyoto, then this other one to this other stop, and then walk for 10-12 minutes, which I'm invariably going to walk in the wrong direction. Walking in the wrong direction is my style. So I decided to go back to Osaka. It was good to have a little train adventure. Meant I could catch up on my diary, which I was getting very behind on. What a strange thing that happened. Someone filmed me while I was writing, right on their phone, which is a bit weird if they're trying to decipher my handwriting. They're lucky. Or maybe that's what they were filming. They're going, this guy is writing, look at that. No respect for the English language, who knows. So I got back to Osaka, had a bit of a wander through the arcades, and looked for something. I realised I hadn't had anything really to eat since a sandwich in the morning, so I found a little, so they have these small bar kind of cafes, and I walked in and said, watashi wa vegetarian desu, which means I am vegetarian, and she said, no. And it's like, oh. Rice and curry. The curry has beef soup, and I was like, yeah, I'll ignore that. I was very hungry by then. I'd started to realise how hungry I was. And so I had that, and it was pretty nice. I had it with some extra eggplant and some green onions. That was good. I saw there was a record shop nearby, so I took one of my Nosferatu records and gave it to the person at the counter. And I think he must have thought, what's going on? And I'm saying, it's a gift, you can have this. And took a photo. So I've got a photo of a confused shop employee holding a Nosferatu record, not quite knowing what's going on. That's cool. And then I also hid a Nosferatu Fjord CD.
That evening I went to Dragon's Gate Wrestling, which was in an outskirt of Osaka itself. I had to catch a train for about half an hour to get to the venue. And when I got off the train, it was in a locked, smaller town kind of feeling area with narrow streets. I walked to the gymnasium and got my tickets. There was a lot more people in the audience at the Dragon's Gate Wrestling, and a younger audience. The wrestling was presented in a very different way. There were MCs who did a long talk at the beginning, all in Japanese, so I don't quite know what they said, but they did say something about smartphones and cameras. So I only took still photos. I didn't want to get chucked out for filming. The wrestling was great. It was very spectacular moves and some great comedy wrestling and great characters. There was a lot more audience participation with this one, with call and response, and the wrestling stables coming out and doing a bit of a chat to the audience. And it was a good show, a very different show to the Noah show that I'd been to earlier in the week. And then there was the streamers. So many streamers.
The giant life-size Gundam robot. To be honest, it's not that big. Angel of the North is bigger. I reckon if they were to build a Black Sabbath's Iron Man life-size robot, it'd be bigger than that. Blacker and heavier and more metal. It's pretty cool. Apparently, it does a show sometime or other. Or it's going to move or something like that, but, you know, whatever.
I'm in the food court of where Gundam is, and I might have got something vegetarian. I've been moved out, well, not moved out, but... So, watashi wa vegetarian desu, and people go, no. So, let's see. Some girls in the queue helped me with this. I've got some wasabi here. I've been wanting some noodles since I've come here, but not been able to have any. You know, there's part of me that keeps thinking, oh, just have some blinking meat. Explore with your tongue. Stuff I haven't tried. But I can't. Anyway, I've got a kind of... A potato cake. A bit of tempura queso. And now for some of my udon noodles, which are chilled. Got a good sauce. That is a good sauce. A nice topping on the salad. Good filling.
So, I got up a bit late to have my usual Tokyo breakfast. So I went for a walk and I found this small cafe, proper old school cafe, smoking. Long time since I've been to a place which you can have smoking doors. And I've got sauteed tofu, miso, and some rice, and what looks like some pickled vegetables, maybe, which is quite exciting. Got my phrase book. Everyone looked very confused when I said when I asked about vegetarian. So I don't know how vegetarian this is. Sometimes you have to turn a blind eye. That's good. Oh. Got sesame seed in it. A little bit of chili in there, which is really good. That's
good. Try a little bit of the mizu. I do like mizu. In fact, I could drink mizu instead of tea. I think it's got egg stirred into it, this. So being vegetarian in Japan, it'd be possible, but I think you've got to do your homework. Being vegan, you really have to do your homework and know where you're eating and stuff like that. So, today it's September the 2nd, and any good story needs a bit of mild danger and peril. And, well, yesterday, and today in a way I guess, is mild danger and peril. After I had my meal at the cafe, I went to try and find an ATM so I could get some more money. My credit card wasn't used. I tried 6 different ATMs and didn't work. So I went back to the hotel and phoned the credit card company and had a chat to them. And that was about as useful as a chocolate teapot, and also cost me two-thirds of all the money I've got left. So that's a bit annoying. And then so my plan today, and from talking to the guy, it might be the ATMs are the problem. I'm going to go to the Tokyo Skytree, and there's a currency exchange places there where I should be able to buy my yen. Or there's also several banks near there, so I can go in there and have a chat with them. So yeah, it's all exciting. I've got my hotel room, so that's okay. I've got a backup 20 quid, which will cover my journey from here to Narita on the 7th. So if all goes not particularly right, the rest of my time in Tokyo will be walking around the local area and drinking miso soup. But this, the hearty vegetable soup, it keeps you going for the day, and it's pretty cheap as well, so that's a good thing. And hey, I need to lose a bit of weight, don't I? Get rid of that, and you know, a bit of walking, a bit of fasting, that'll all help, won't it? So let's see what happens. Mild peril and danger. So, mild peril possibly averted, I think, perhaps. I've walked to the Tokyo Skytree, which is that thing there, and found a Japan Post Office, and had a go on their machine. Thank you ever so much, Rob and George, for putting me on to the Japan Post Office machines. I'm celebrating with a celebratory banana and a drink of water. I took out some yen, and I'm trying to work out how much I did take out. And then I went back to go and take a little bit more out, and it wouldn't let me. So maybe I've got enough. Let's see, eh? So a celebratory banana, and then I think I'm going to go back to the hotel, have a breather, and then work my way towards the wish list gallery
so I can put the fanzine together that I've been making. So there you go. Oh. A little bit something that gets you out of breath and makes your heart rate go a bit faster. It's good for you, isn't it? Maybe I took a wrong turning in this wander of mine that I've been taking. Get to see some different places that you wouldn't normally see in a totally lost wander. So, it's Sunday at Yoyogi Park, which is known for its dancing rockabillies and parading youth of Tokyo. So I'm going to try and find these dancing rockabillies and see what that's all about. I don't think I gave you an update about yesterday. Yesterday was quite busy and fun and stuff. I woke up in the morning, found out the address of a Kinko copying place, went to find that. I went and had some soba in a soba noodle bar, did the last drawing to my fanzine, and then got it printed in the Kinko. And then folded, went back to the hotel, folded, and then went off to Yokohama to meet George Juniper, who is a YouTuber who used to live in Brighton but now lives in Japan. And so we did some bits with him and drank some sake, went to some craft ale bars, and yeah, hung out in Yokohama, which is that was nice. And now I'm off to find the rockabillies, then go back to the Wishlist Gallery, give them a couple of fanzines, which are, let's have a look, I've got here. Ooh, that's the back, that's the front. Ooh. And yeah, let's get on with the day, shall we? It's my last Monday in Japan. Oh, it's still going very quickly. At the moment, I'm walking towards the Sky Tree. Well, towards in one of my usual roundabout ways. But anyway, yes, because I know there's a Japan post office there and I need to see if my credit card works just for some money for the last couple of days and make sure I can get the train to Narita on a Wednesday afternoon. And last night was fun. I didn't find the dancing rockabillies in Yogi Park, but I did find a rather quite a big shrine
which I went and had a look at. That was quite nice. I had a good walk. Then I went to Wishless and gave them a copy, or several copies of my Japan fanzine. And then I went to Shinjuku, where I found the Nightingale. There's an area in Shinjuku which is like a little square with a little block which has lots of very small bars, and they all kind of have a sort of specialist interest, you know, whether it's, you know, sakis or metal country and stuff. And there's one there called the Nightingale, which it's experimental music it's interested in. And so I went there, found it. Thank you, Ardwell Fisher, for your rough clues. But, you know, part of it is secret, you know, you're not quite sure when you walk through the door if you're in the right place. And I gave them a Godspunk and a Noise for R2 CD, which they played, and they said they liked it, which is good. I was kind of chuffed by that, of yeah, they liked my music. No. And then a random American couple came in, and you could see them kind of twitching as the various music was playing, and had a chat to them, said, oh yeah, this bar's quite well known for its experimental music, and had a chat. They were from Oregon, and yeah, so that was quite nice. And then I went home, and now I've woken up, and I'm going to find the post office, and then, fingers crossed, I should be going on another adventure on the underground somewhere. Let's see what happens. Today is my last full day in Japan, so I'm gonna pack stuff in, or I'm just gonna randomly wander around. For me, that's packing stuff in. I've got plans, and exciting stuff has happened. So I'm near the Tokyo Dome at the moment, which is near the Kodokan, which is like the main base for judo, and it's got a big library and a bit of a museum about judo and Jigoro Kano, who invented judo. So I'm going to go there and pay respects, and, you know, because my parents used to run a judo club, my sisters fought for the country, so I used to do judo. I wasn't as good as the rest of the family. And I've also, when I was working out where I was going to go, my good friend Freddie Mercurio, the Lucha Libre wrestler, said I should go to this wrestling shop, which is around the corner from here. I've just found it, but it wasn't open until 3, so I thought, well, I'll wait till it opens and go and say hello and see if I can get a wrestling mask there, because that's something I want to do. And then, very, very excitingly, I'm going to be doing a gig tomorrow. Oh, no, well, not tomorrow, tonight, in the Nightingale, which is a small experimental bar. And I've made some field recordings, and I'm going to do a bit of live manipulation of music there, just so I can say, ladies and gentlemen, I played in Japan. Oh yeah, at the Nightingale, legendary underground place. I'm just so hipster. So,
Freddie Mercury on. I put your t-shirt on and I found the Fukumen wrestling shop. But look there, the 6th, I guess that's closed. Oh, I came on the wrong day. What a sad face I have.
So there we have it, my last hearty breakfast vegetable soup. It's been a great 2 weeks. I've really enjoyed it. There were moments of almost mild danger, moments of even perhaps romance, but much excitement. And I even got to play a gig last night, which I think I was pretty pleased with what I did. What have I got out of this trip? I don't know. It'll take time for my brain to process everything. But I shall be back to Japan to investigate you further.